When you install programs on your computer, they come with default settings. Excel does too. Now, some of these settings might be working against you because you have your way of using Excel. There are specifically 4 settings that you should review now to see if you need to update them. Let me show you. So the first setting you might want to update is this here. When I start to write a formula, just anything, doesn't matter. When I press enter, I move automatically to the next cell. So every time you press enter or you type a number, you press enter, you move automatically to the next cell. Now, I usually write a lot of formulas and then I want to stay on the same cell, not move down so that I can easily copy my formula down. Now, there is a way that you can do this with a shortcut key. So instead of pressing enter, you can do control enter. But I don't always remember to do this. I just want enter to stay on the same cell. There is a setting for that. You go to File, Options, Advanced, and right here, you can define what happens when you press enter. By default, it moves down. You could move right up. That would be weird, but if you want to do a prank on your colleague, you could do this, or to the left. But if you don't want it to move anywhere, like in my case, you just uncheck this and then you click on OK. And now every time you press enter, you stay on the same cell. And we can just try by just typing any type of formula and pressing enter, and we stay right here. By the way, since we're talking about adjusting settings, you should also check your YouTube settings to see if you're subscribed to this channel. This way you don't miss out on any other tips that you might find useful in the future. The next setting you might want to update is your autocomplete settings. If you deal with long text, long names, or long phrases that keep repeating in different Excel files, you might want to do this. So let's say I need to write the company name a lot, so Office Plus Headquarters. And sometimes I make mistakes and I don't even notice it. It's going to save me a lot of time to have an autocomplete for this. We can easily set this up by going to File, Options. This time we're going to go to Proofing. Right here we can change how Excel corrects and formats the text as we type. When you click on AutoCorrect Options, you are going to see a big list here, and this is going to be dependent on your language. The great thing is that you can add your own stuff here. Let's say every time I type in OP, I want to see Office Plus Headquarters. Click on Add, and then OK, and OK. Now, every time I type in OP and I add a space, it's going to put in Office Plus Headquarters, and it doesn't matter which workbook I'm in. I'm going to open a brand new Excel workbook by pressing Control N, and then I type in OP space and I get Office Plus Headquarters. Next setting you might want to review is your custom lists. You know how every time you type in the months here and then you drag this down, you automatically see the next months? Where is this coming from? It's coming from your custom lists, but it doesn't have to be restricted to months only. You can add any list you want. You could have a list of your departments if that's something that you keep using in multiple workbooks. To do that, go back to File, Options, Advanced, scroll all the way to the end, and you're going to see Edit Custom Lists. When you click on this, you're going to see some predefined custom lists for you. So the ones that I just showed you are right here. You have the ability to add your own custom list by just entering here whatever you want and then clicking on Add. Or since I have my departments in different cells here, I am going to import the list from cells. So I'm just going to click on this and drag this. I'll include the word department as well because it's easy to remember. And then I'm going to click on this, import. It's going to add it here. Then click on OK and OK. Now, every time I type in department and then I drag this down, I can see my list here. And if I continue dragging, I just get a repeated list. Now, this isn't just for this workbook. It's a global setting that applies to all my workbooks. So let's open a blank workbook by pressing Control N. And this time, I'm just going to start from the first department. It was athletics. Let me just make sure I spell it correctly. Now I'm going to drag this down and I get the other departments. What happens if I start from admin? No problem. Just drag this down and you get the next departments, and then it starts repeating itself over and over again. If you don't want the header department in there, just skip that when you import your list. Next setting is to define your preferred pivot table layout. Now, this annoyed me for the longest time because check this out. If we go ahead and insert a pivot table, let's just insert it on a new sheet, we get this standard layout from Excel. I always had to go and make adjustments to this. I like to have my report layout in tabular form. I don't want to see these subtotals. So I had to go and turn this off. I don't want to see that button there. So I would go here, turn that off as well. And I'd also go to pivot table options and I would turn off auto fit column widths on update because it annoyed me that every time I would refresh this, this would jump and auto fit. You can avoid these steps altogether. If you have Office 365, you can define a custom layout for all your pivot tables across all your spreadsheets. You go to File, Options, under Data this time, you're going to see Make Changes to the Default Layout of Pivot Tables, and you can edit that layout. You could do it manually by defining what you want to see for subtotals, for your grand totals, the report layout, whether you want it in compact form, tabular, or outline form, and also your pivot table options. That annoying autofit can be turned off globally here. Now you can do this manually if you want, but you don't have to. If you've already created a pivot table with the layout that you want, all you need to do is import that layout here. So you just click on import and the settings are brought over. Now when I go to pivot table option, that tick mark is gone. I'm going to click on OK and OK. And now that's my default layout across all my workbooks. Whenever I go and insert a new pivot table, let's this time just put it down here, I get the layout that I just defined. In case you want to update the colors of your pivot table, you can do that from design. Under pivot table styles, you can use another layout. You can also customize a layout based on your own brand colors. To make this as default, right mouse click and set as default. And this will remain the default for this spreadsheet. Okay, so I know I said four settings, but while I was recording this video, I remembered two more. You know how every time you open the Excel application, you come to this standard view where you can pick one of your recent workbooks, click on blank workbook, or click on open here. Now you might personally find this useful, but your working style might be different. You might prefer to work via Explorer. So you might just open Explorer and open whatever file that you want directly from here. And if you open the Excel application, you just want to get a blank workbook. You don't want to go through that startup page. You can adjust that setting by going to Options, under General, scroll all the way down. Here for Startup Options, uncheck this box to show the start screen when this application starts and click on OK. Now, every time you click on Excel, you get a blank workbook. The last setting I want to share with you is brand new, so new that you probably don't have it yet. If you go to Excel Options, go to Advanced, scroll a little bit down, there's a new section called Automatic Data Conversion. It's currently in beta in Office Insiders. You have the ability to change some of the default data conversion behavior of Excel. One annoying one is removing leading zeros when you're entering numbers, numbers like product codes, phone numbers, and so on. One other useful one is this one right here. When loading a CSV file or similar file, notify me of automatic data conversions. So if this is checked, and it should be checked by default once you get these settings, what happens when you open a CSV file is this. So over here in File Explorer, I have this CSV file and we can see in the preview, these are the product codes that I have. The first two and the last one have zeros in front. This one is just a standard number. Now, when I open this with this feature on, I automatically get this notification that by default, Excel will perform the following data conversions in this file and it's going to remove the leading zeros. So this is how it's going to look like by default, so by the old default. Now we get this notification and we can choose not to convert. This way the zeros come with and we don't run into any mistakes or errors when we're analyzing our numbers. So that's the list of my suggested settings to update in Excel. Let me know in the comments if there is a specific one that you found useful, or maybe some other ones that you'd like to share with us. That's it for today. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.